Hey guys, it's Celestia, and today I'm going to be talking about a trend of very particular art gatekeeping that has been, like most things, making me furious. And that trend is people, both on YouTube and elsewhere, telling artists to stop drawing pretty Pinterest girls. First of all, what an exceptionally specific thing to insult people for drawing. Like, I don't go into your house telling you to stop using the smiling moon emoji specifically. So don't break into my condo and tell me I can't draw a very specific type of portrait of a very specific type of woman whose photo I happen to find on Pinterest. It's already scummy to police the kind of art that people draw, but it's just stupid to single out such a ridiculously particular aspect of a trend and target it as bad. I've spent a lot of my life being told not to draw anime or not to draw fan art, so after having dealt with that bullshit for as long as I have, being told now not to draw one tiny, minuscule subset of portrait subjects because everyone is just feels so exceptionally, hilariously redundant in comparison. To the point that it's genuinely funny to me to see how passionately people will whine online about it. But while I find it amusing to say the least, others might actually stop drawing stuff that they enjoy because they're sensitive to that kind of behavior and criticism. And that's why I want to talk about this trend today. Before we get into it, if you don't know what I'm referring to, I'll show some examples on screen of what I mean by Pinterest girls. They're pretty ladies, usually shown from the shoulders up, often with unnatural hair colors and cute accessories, and usually looking at the camera as more of a headshot than a candid. Drawing these women based on the photos of them posted on Pinterest has become an undeniable trend, and while I am openly criticizing people who shit on that trend, I am not trying to argue that it isn't a huge, mainstream type of subject matter. And I very much understand the mentality of people who are tired of seeing art like this. But there's a big difference between being tired of seeing a certain type of art, at which point you could just unfollow these artists, and telling all artists everywhere that that type of art is bad, and that no one should draw it. And it's that particular distinction that I want to make and discuss today. So now we're going to go over all the common arguments against drawing Pinterest girls, and I'm going to tell you why they're dumb. Actually, a lot of them are based in really valid logic, and for the most part, I agree with a lot of them, but using those arguments to insult and belittle an entire subset of artists rather than just using them to explain your opinion is dumb, so I'm sticking to it. So, first of all, there are two main types of arguments that I've heard. First, there's the constructive feedback coming from a good place that I've heard from other artists as well as art YouTubers that I really look up to. And then there's the malicious, petty, not even mildly constructive whining of both artists and audiences, largely on Twitter and lolcow. Yes, I look at lolcow now, and don't even try to tell me that the rest of you haven't checked it out too with everything that's been going on. Yes, the majority of the site is a cesspool that does little more than disgust me, but they do still have a lot of opinions about artists drawing Pinterest girls that warrant some thought. And just because I think they're awful doesn't mean I'm going to ignore the arguments they present that are actually based in something reasonable. So bear with me, I'm not happy about it either. First, let's talk about the constructive, well-meaning justifications that I've seen used when telling people to stop drawing like this. Ergo Josh actually made a video about this a while ago that was called Stop Drawing These Girls, that has since been privated for some reason, otherwise I would link it, because while I fundamentally disagree with the premise of it, the points that he made were strong, reasonable, and ultimately just made with the intention to help artists grow to the best of their ability. Essentially, his argument, which is shared by many, was comprised of the following. First of all, that art like that is boring, because it's largely all the same. The expressions of the models are all unimaginative and neutral, and it doesn't push you out of your comfort zone and help you grow as an artist by challenging you. And before I move on, let me just say right now that I completely agree with all of that. And while I will be addressing why I think that still doesn't mean it's okay to tell people not to draw it, that doesn't mean I don't recognize the validity of the arguments or the good intentions behind them. Next, the petty stuff. The criticisms in this category that I've heard the most are as follows. It's too simple and easy, and it's basically just copying a reference directly and subsequently shows no skill. They're all women. Everyone is doing it, so the artists that jump on that trend are just selling out and doing it because it's popular. There's too much of it, and it's all the same. It's unoriginal and has no creativity. And again, as an artist who spent a significant part of my life being told that I'm drawing the wrong things, the people who gatekeep what art is and isn't real or good almost always have the exact same reasons why. I've heard the exact same arguments against drawing anime, fan art, flowers, landscapes, all portraits. There's really no end to the list of subject matter that people will attack as being bad for no reason more complex or significant than that there's a lot of it and it doesn't appeal to them personally. And to me, that's how you distinguish the people who actually have something to say on the matter from the people who don't. Because if your only real argument is either personal preference or a baseless assumption about an entire group of artists based on one particular thing they happen to draw, you can pretty much be written off, in my opinion, as an exceptionally whiny person who will find something negative to insult about literally anything they dislike. All of these arguments are just opinions and assumptions glorified as facts, and all of them set out not to help the artists drawing this content, but to bring them down for drawing it at all. The only exception to this is the criticism that they're all women, which is a lot. If this is coming from the perspective of someone saying that you can't fully improve at art if you only draw subjects of one gender, I can understand it. But I am confident when I postulate that the majority of people making this argument just have problems with women getting a large amount of representation, and that's a whole new level of stupid that would take its own video to address. Now that we've gotten the arguments against drawing Pinterest girls out of the way, what's my argument against them? Well, in response to literally every point, I can pretty much sum up how I feel about them by just saying, so what? It's genuinely the basis of all of my arguments here, but let me get into more detail and address each point individually because I'm gonna go out on a limb here and say that you guys probably didn't click this video to hear me give a two-word response. So I'll address the productive, well-meaning criticisms first, starting with, this type of art doesn't push you past your comfort zone or challenge you as an artist, because the expressions and poses all tend to be the same, and it's subsequently not a viable way to improve your work. And yes, that is 100% true, and far be it from me to try to deny that or argue with it. My problem with this argument isn't that it's wrong, but that it's based on two wrong assumptions. One, that everyone who draws is trying to improve. And two, that in order to improve, you have to be constantly studying, pushing your artistic boundaries, and only trying new things. First of all, not everyone who draws even wants to improve. Some people are just drawing as a hobby, for fun, because they like it, and the assumption that either these people should still never be drawing what they enjoy because it's too easy, or that everyone who draws is trying to reach a professional skill level, is presumptuous at best and boldly arrogant at worst. But say you do want to improve at art, and you do want to push yourself past what you're comfortable with to do so. Does that mean that you should only ever draw what you think will help you improve, and only draw to study or else you'll never get better? Of course not! And the abundance of people out there pushing that narrative is appalling to me. Yes, to improve at art, you need to draw more than just headshots of pretty girls with neutral expressions. But that does not mean that you can't ever draw them. And that's an important distinction that people have largely failed to make. It's important to do art studies, to practice your weak points, to tackle new artistic challenges. But it's also important to make art that you enjoy just because you enjoy it. Every artist has comfort art, the subject matter that's easy for them, that they love making, and that they'll draw just for fun, just for the sake of drawing. This comfort art is imperative when it comes to maintaining your passion for art and avoiding burnout, which is one of the many reasons that so many creators demeaning that comfort art, which, let's be honest, is exactly what Pinterest girl art usually is detrimental. I wholeheartedly agree that you shouldn't draw art like this exclusively if your goal is to improve, but you can draw comfort art and push your boundaries and grow, and there is absolutely nothing wrong with doing both. Not every piece you make has to demonstrate an immense increase in skill. Some pieces should be made because you like them, and it doesn't need to be more complicated than that. Now, let's get to the petty arguments, because these have little to no merit, and I'm gonna have a really good time tearing them apart. First, the point that this kind of art is boring, oversaturated, and all the same. I really, really hate this one, because I cannot stress enough that there will be people whining the same redundant rhetoric at any artist with any type of subject matter. You paint landscapes, environments, flowers? Boring. All the same. Motel art. You make realistic portraits? Boring. All the same. Just a copy of a picture. No creativity. You draw anime? Boring. All the same. Overdone because it's just so easy. You draw fan art? Guess what? Boring. All the same. Not even your characters. Has no originality. Do you see what I mean? People use this argument for every type of art that they personally dislike. And the fundamental basis of it is just that there's a lot of it, therefore it's bad and it shows no creativity. The problem is that there's a lot of every type of art. Humans have been around and making art for a very long time now. And to suggest that the only type of art that has merit is art that's completely, utterly unique is the most redundant, stupid statement you could possibly make, because at this point, that's impossible. Yes, there are a lot of Pinterest girl art pieces going around right now, and no, making them is not particularly original. But there's a lot of every type of art going around, because there are almost 8 billion people on this planet, and a good number of them are making it. True originality is borderline impossible to achieve. Everything is inspired by something else that already exists. And in my opinion, the closest an artist can come to making something original is interpreting that inspiration in their own way, no matter what medium or subject matter they're using. People who shit on art for just being another rendition of the same stuff that everyone's doing don't actually have anything real to criticize other than the fact that they don't like that particular thing that everyone's doing. And the funniest part of that is that I guarantee you that these are the same people who like other art that there happens to be a ton of, and they don't extend those same criticisms to that because it appeals to their own personal preference. Building on this point, let's talk about the next argument from these lovely individuals, which is that people who draw Pinterest girls are just jumping on the bandwagon because it's a trend and they want to be popular. And there are two things about this that make me want to scream. First of all, don't you dare assume that everyone who draws something that happens to be currently popular is doing so because it's popular. Do you know why trends exist? Do you know why things become popular in the first place? It's because people like them. There's something inherently likable and appealing about that content that makes people both want to see it and create it. The arrogance that it takes to assume that everyone who draws something popular is trying to cash in on it is sincerely unbelievable to me, because you'd have to deliberately ignore the very basis of what popularity is and why it exists in order to believe that in any real capacity. Yes, of course some people are doing that, but that's the case for any group of people doing any thing. Everyone's motivation is different, even if their actions are the same. And to suggest that because some artists are doing it for popularity, all of them are, is taking confirmation bias to a moronic extreme that some people are intentionally failing to acknowledge. The second reason this argument makes me scream is because who cares if some artists are drawing these trends for popularity? Are you actually gonna tell me that you've never done something to fit in, to get attention, to receive validation from your peers, even if it's by doing something you might not have done otherwise? The art market is exceptionally oversaturated, and artists everywhere are putting their heart and soul into work that ends up getting little to no engagement or attention. Drawing something popular because it's popular isn't some brainless, shallow, superficial practice that's only done by artists who are selling out. It's a borderline desperate attempt to compete against the plethora of other art that's plastered over every platform. And 90% of the time, it comes from a place of just being desperate for any kind of validation or confirmation that their art is good and people like it. Sure, sometimes it's to make money, and sometimes it's to get followers and engagement. But once again, so what? Everyone wants those things, especially if they're trying to make a career out of art. I'm sick and tired of artists being demonized for wanting to make a living off of their art like anyone else in any other field would. Wanting to make money off of something you love doesn't mean you don't love it. It means that you want to pursue it so much that you can afford to spend all of your time doing it. The last dumbass lolcow argument against drawing Pinterest girls is that you're just copying a reference, so it shows no skill to be able to do it, even if you do it well. And first of all, let me just say, if you make this argument, DM me. I'll send you a Pinterest photo and you can replicate it for me, and once you're done, we'll talk about how little skill it takes. Regardless, I'm including this one because there actually is some basis to it. Yes, redrawing a picture does demonstrate less skill than creating a completely original piece. It is easier. But not only does that not mean that it's easy or requires no skill, which you'd think would go without saying for anyone with a brain cell, but this criticism is also based on the assumption that, once again, these Pinterest portraits are the only things the artists who draw them can do. To suggest that an artist has no skill because they happen to draw a few things that require less of it than their other work does is just deliberately ignorant, which a lot of these arguments are. I personally draw Pinterest girls to wind down, to study faces, or just because they're pretty and I like them. I also make pieces with full backgrounds and dynamic poses that are almost entirely from imagination. I don't go to your work and tell you that because you work at Starbucks, your professional skills are completely limited to making coffee, regardless of whatever else you do. So once again, don't come to my condo and tell me that my Pinterest girl portraits are the summation of my artistic ability. Just don't come to my condo. Ultimately, in conclusion, if you hate art of Pinterest girls and you're tired of seeing it, unfollow the artists that you see making it. It's that simple. Get off your high horse and stop acting like you have the right to tell artists that not only do you know what real art is, but that theirs isn't. If you draw or want to draw Pinterest girls because it makes you happy and you enjoy it, don't let pretentious assholes who think they're the authority on what real art is make you think that it's bad or that you shouldn't. Do what brings you joy, and let others do what brings them joy. Stop gatekeeping and policing what art should or shouldn't be drawn. Sorry, I got a little heated there, but we all know I'm full of rage at this point, so it shouldn't come as much of a surprise. I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. Please leave a like and subscribe if you did, and I'll see you next week.